Hey, how's everyone doing out there today? I hope you're finding lots of stuff. I have a couple things to show you today that I found at a thrift store, and also wanted to give you a couple little tips. One tip that I probably don't have to give very many of you, but I just want to give you a reminder. Look in boxes. When you're somewhere, don't just look at the top of a box and assume that you know what's in that box and just kind of glance over some of the top boxes. Dig. That's what we are. We're pickers, so dig. That's how I found, I've already shown this a few weeks ago, but that's how I found this. It was down in the very bottom of a box at a thrift store, and they have tons of boxes to go through, so I spend plenty of time digging in those boxes, making sure I see every even small item. So I come across this. Thanks, Vintage Fetcher, for letting me know that this is a rare color. So $1 piece, I'll end up getting $25 to $40 for it. It is in good working condition. Another idea for you to keep an eye out for cords. I did not have a cord for this particular Game Boy Advance SP is what this is. And so I ended up ordering one for a couple dollars. So that's a couple dollars off of the little bit of profit that I'll make, but still no big deal. It only cost me a couple dollars. But somebody out there sold this. Keep your eye open for cords for games and such. And Redneck Picker also talked a while back about getting cords for old coffee pots and the older style cords. If you see those, pick them up. If you can get them, usually you can get them free or for little or nothing. And somebody out there like myself needs a cord and is willing to pay a couple of dollars for it. So something to keep an eye out for. All right, on a few of the items that I found, before I show you the items that I found at thrift store, let me show you an item that I picked up for trade from my good buddy that traded me that little banjo toy banjo that you saw in a previous video. All right, there it is. What we call a locker. My guess is from the 40s. Here, I'll put my foot up there to show you kind of the size of it. Look at about 18 inches there, probably about two foot wide. Look at the latches on that. And the copper corners. Check out those latches, aren't they cool? Thick, look at that handle. Alright. Check it out. It's got writing on the inside. This is JWW. Well, I can't hardly even read it. Hang on. Weatherall is the name of the fella. It's got com.navy3923 on it. Mr. W.B. Weatherall from Eupora, Mississippi. Look at that thing. It's in great condition. The only issues on it is there in the corner. It's got a little, needs to be, it's been pulled out a little bit, but that's it. Everything else is beautiful, and that's not even noticeable. It's on that, on the back side of it. Isn't that thing fine? My goodness. Look at this. Somebody painted it. Oh my gracious. That thing is just fine. If anybody knows the value of these things or could possibly value it, it's beyond me. But I just couldn't. I had to do some trade on it to get it. Just a beautiful piece.
How about that foot locker? Isn't that thing awesome? If you know anything about those, the value of them or whatever, you let me know. That thing, I'm going to say it's from World War II. It's by the looks of it from me around that time, early 40s. All right, I just wanted to show you the finds that I got from the thrift store, a trip that I made the other day. All that you're fixing to see, I paid $24 and some change for it. And I'm going to start with one of the pieces behind me for Miss Katie Marie. You'll appreciate that. You may have already noticed it. Check it out. $1. This is, I'm going to guess, my guess would be early 60s. I think possibly late 50s on this little ukulele. Got a good working condition. I've got to do a little work on it. Somebody, the bridge evidently may have pulled off or whatever. That's an easy fix for myself. I'll pull these screws out, fill it with glue, fill it with wood filler, and glue this back down. But for $1, for a ukulele of this age, tell me if I'm wrong, Katie, but I'm saying around $75 to $100. Beautiful, beautiful little piece. It's got to be cleaned up. I hadn't done anything to it other than just tune it up and play it. Put that right back there. All right, I'm going to take the camera off and show you a few more items. Okay, here we are with all the other items. Like I said, I'm in at $24 and some change. I always got to get the musical instruments. I keep them. Woo-hoo! That's probably a learning toy from some school or something to teach rhythm for kids. Hey, check out the art, Terminal 99. Got to get some art. That's probably some local person that did this piece. It's a drawing with some watercolor, but it's done very well. I really like that piece. All right, Picker Nation, check out the Hot Wheels. Look at this. This was at the thrift store. Everything is in it. Look at this. The car. The car is still in its original package. This thing's never been played with. Speaking of Hot Wheels, for you, Picker Nation. How you like that? Hey, always picking up those. There's some knives. Oh, that's Bakugan, by the way. They close up. Most of the time, they're little small circular toys, if y'all are familiar with those. I throw them in lots. This is one of those markers for a business. Always keep an eye out for Imaginext. The same as I keep out for Lego figures. Imaginext figures also sell. He's just a random little builder. But alright, Zelda book. This book, you can check them out. They sell for around $30, sometimes more, sometimes less. This one, I actually have it up already. Got a bid on it, $7.99 already. Still got 5 days to go. Got these games, Sherlock Holmes PC games.
couple of the PlayStation games, Die Hard and Jet Moto 2. Couldn't pass it up. It's a Mickey Rain, whatever you call those things. I think you buy these at Disney World on a rainy day. They make a ton of money, I'm sure. Always pick up little Disney items, especially if they're from the Disney store, since they no longer have the Disney stores. Pick those up. Still had a tag on it. Just a ornament there. Picked up a brand spanking new notebook card. Now I realize this is a wireless G notebook card. Hey, who uses these anymore? Well, people who aren't always up to date are always looking for older items. All right. Math Success 2005, original retail, $39.99. Don't know how that will do. We'll find out. A couple of plug and play from EA Sports. This is hockey and football. This does work. I've already tested it. It's in great condition. I've got a nice Wii remote. Perfectly good condition. Got some ink. Never pass up the ink. Still in date. I don't know if you can see that. It's June 2013. Still in date. All right. Always pick up the Thomas Train. I throw those together in a lot. They do real well. This is a drum pad. It's actually a HQ two-sided drum pad. These are some high-dollar items. This one, actually, I've got it up for sale for $18. They sell brand new and close to $40. But I've got it up for $18. And a little Ravens jersey with the football pants. A little suit there. I picked that up. And a little Snoopy things. My wife loves Snoopy. I always pick up Snoopy stuff. And a Pentax camera. I don't know that these do all that well, but it was just in a box of stuff. Like I say, I got it. Got all that stuff for 24 and some change. Can't beat it with a stick.
Okay, those are my items for this week. Hey, just want to let y'all know, for those who have entered the contest, I've not given up on the contest. The Pepsi bag won't go up until today. I had a kind of a setback on some things. My youngest daughter had to have some testing on some surgery that she had back in the summer. So I kind of had to postpone the selling of putting that one up. So that one actually will be going up tonight. I will take all the bids that have already come in, and I will put those aside. And all those people are entered into the contest. So the results of that will be coming up when everything finally sells. So hadn't forgot about it. Well, all right. Y'all have a blessed day, and go out and find some stuff. Love God and love others.